Hey all, welcome back to another Yu-Gi-Oh! Duel Links video, and today we're going to go over the new Marik event. So Marik has returned for the second time, and this time he's brought some powerful new cards. Not competitive new cards, but powerful. So why don't we just check out the event page really quickly. I'm not going to spend too much time on that. We've already gone through a similar event with Marik before in the past, but he does need an updated farm deck, so we'll definitely have to talk about that. So basically this Marik event is broken up into a few different pieces. The first one is just, you know, obtain a whole bunch of points. That way you can climb through and get all the cards and gems, gold, orbs, everything like that that you can get through the advancements. And you can also unlock Marik if you don't already have him. And this is also a chance to get a second Lava Golem, which is really cool. I have not been farming him too much, but I'm already 1.5 in basically, and it's only been a day or two, so that's not too bad. And then come December 10th, there'll be more stuff that occurs within the Duel World. As you can see, there was like some of these stuff right here, and that'll reoccur, and you can do some new stuff. I'm not really completely sure, but if we go to the event details, it's going to tell us that. Let's just scroll down here. And this shows us that we can actually obtain the Winged Dragon of Ra by defeating Yami Marik at level 50 version, starting from December 14th at 10 o'clock my time. So there's going to be a little bit of stuff in between that, not too sure about that, but on the 14th you should be able to get a copy of it, and it looks like it's going to be a prismatic copy too, which is pretty crazy, so that's pretty cool. And then besides that, we actually have a little bit of character introduction, some pretty cool stuff there, some ace, and then just some of the cards that they're looking to obtain. So let's just talk about two new cards that I kind of want to mention, and that's Ra's Disciple. So Ra's Disciple, when this card is summoned, you can special summon up to two Ra Disciples from your hand or deck. They cannot be tributed except for the tribute summon of Slayer the Sky Dragon, Olive the Tormentor, or the Winged Dragon of Ra. You cannot special summon monsters except by the effect of Ra's Disciple. So it's pretty cool. I've actually already managed to get three copies of them myself. You do get some from leveling up through the event, and the drops don't seem too bad this time around. So that's obviously a card you want to get if you ever want to play some God card decks. But it's not going to see too much competitive play, that's for sure. And then the one I think that might have a few applications, probably in farming, is the Magical Stone Excavation. Discard two cards and target one spell card in your graveyard, add it back to your hand. That's pretty sweet. I saw this in a few zombie decks back in the day, but I think this is a pretty decent card, and I think you should try to get three copies if you can. Might be useful in the future. Alright, so there's the event. Now let's talk about the farm deck that I'm using. So I'm using Bandit Keith, and I'm using Ojamas. So Ojamas is something that's been splashing around the internet. It's great. It's great for stopping your opponent from using monsters, and that application is definitely needed here. And that is great, because Marik needs three monsters on this side of the field in order to tribute out his Winged Dragon of Ra. So if you're able to block that off, it's perfect. He won't be able to bring out his Ra. That's his main threat. But on top of that, Ojamas are great because you can easily get out the Ojama Knight just using any two Ojama monsters, and that way you can stop other things he's going to bring out, like the Mass Beast, and keep your life point safe. In addition, he doesn't actually use any of his equip masks or his Nightmare Wheel on your zero attack Ojamas that are in defense position, so that keeps you safe for there as well. So that's a great little AI thing that was found out. And it's actually quite easy to bring out a few, and this is a great dual assessment deck because you are fusion summoning. So let's just quickly talk about the deck choices. I'm running three Ojama Blues. A lot of people are only running one to two of these. I think three is great because sometimes I like to get the extra draws off it. I like to see this card in my opening hand. I think it's just basically an Ojama, but better. And then I also toss in six vanilla Ojamas. That works pretty well for me for the whole consistency theme. And then I wanted to add, I actually don't even have a Fusion Gate still, so I'm actually using a Fusion Sage, which is another fourth card to fusion summon out with. And that just starts with my polymerization is the key card to bring it out. And then I also tossed in Legacy of the Yatugarasu, and that is my prismatic pickup I picked up from the Gacy Cup rewards. So that lets me just draw a card, and it's a trap, so it adds an extra 100 to my score, then plus another 200 because it's prismatic, so an extra 300. And just alone with the glossies and everything else you do with this deck, it gets me 7,900. So this puts me to 8,200, so over 8,000. That's why I use that. And I think restart is the key skill, because you want to see a polymerization in your hand, or a way of getting polymerization in your hand right away on the first turn, because you want to bring out that Ojama Knight first turn every game. And there is ways of making this more consistent that you can do that, but this is the best one I can build, and I think this is one of the best ones most people can build. I think it's a good balance between monster count and spell and trap card count for fusion summoning. So this is my most optimal build. All right, and let's move on to the actual replay that I'm going to show you guys. But if you guys had more questions on what specific farm cards do, I actually have a new video that I posted just a little while ago that goes into depth about farm cards and skills, and I'm going to link that down below, and a little card at the top. And it's just a great way to fill in any gaps of knowledge that you may have through farming, so I recommend it. Alright, so first turn, I drew Polymerization and two Ojamas. So that's the most perfect hand you can draw. If you draw this on your first turn, or something similar to this, or you might need to take one hit, but if you can get this out in like the first two turns, first two of your turns, you're safe. The farm's successful, basically, as is right there. You just gotta make sure you don't deck out before him. So just place your Ojama, take up two of his zones, and pass. There you go. That's basically the farm. And you just gotta keep stalling, just keep doing whatever you're doing. Play your cards to let you draw. One thing I do gotta recommend is do not attack into his monsters. You do not want your life points too low, because then Marik will use his cards that do burn you. And if he does have lethal with that, you will actually utilize that. Don't play your Ojama country yet. You can definitely set it if you want, but you don't want to play it yet. He might see the attack as a threat. Right now he does not. And then another important thing to keep in mind is he does have Lava Golem, so do not have two monsters on the field at the same time during your opponent's turn. That is very key. Trust me, he will Lava Golem you, and then you will have a very unsuccessful farm. So just keep the one Ojama Knight out there until the final turn. Alright, final turn, draw. Alright, so the last combo piece is now in our hand. Now the first thing that you want to do is you probably want to switch this to attack position. You want to fuse out your next Ojama Knight, that's kind of key. And I like to do it in this order just so I have a mental kind of pathway to fall that's not going to let me mess up as easily. So you want to make sure your Ojama Knight's in attack position. That's going to just be a pattern for your brain to summon up the next one in attack position. You'd hate to summon out one of the cards in the wrong position. And I activate Ojama Country. This shows me that's all on attack. That way when I summon up my vassal, I don't accidentally select a different monster for my secret pass to the treasures. There we go. So that's vassal's now been equipped with that. I use the union attack. Now you just gotta make sure you select the vassal again. And you're gonna use the second union attack. Now, this is key. I didn't mention this in the deck part of the profile, but you need to have a way of stopping his nightmare wheel. So enter the battle phase. Now if you have anti-magic arrows, it will prompt you once you're in the battle phase. Activate that. That's gonna shut down his back row. Then you can attack, no problemo. And there you go. That's all the damage you need. You didn't take any damage during the duel. There's no comeback victory, just plain victory, and no damage bonus there. So pretty easy, plus you got the fusion summon bonus. So this is a 7,000 base farm at least. And it's easily obtainable to over 8,000 if you just toss in just a few Colossi's, maybe a prismatic or two as well. So there we have it. Just building up that score. And like I said, 8,200. And yeah, nothing too great here. As you guys can see, I have a fairly decent amount. I have zero of the magical stone excavations yet, but I have basically three of everything else, so that's not too bad. I thank you guys very much for watching. Again, if you ever have any comments, questions, concerns, make sure to leave them down below, and I'll be sure to answer them as quickly as I can to the best of my ability. I hope to catch you in the next one. As always, peace. We'll be right back.